Peace, what's going on, family? This is part three. Putting in that work. I told you this is going to be a series. I know a lot of you, you know, you're not used to this kind of stuff because you're overlooking a lot of things that's going on. I'm SHU AMUN RA, and I want to say Hotep to whoever's out there that's paying attention. Listen here, the black man, the black woman, who should we be dating in the melanin dark race? And why do we have a problem dating other melanin dark people who speak different languages? And also, we're talking about the good, the bad, and the ugly here in America and around the world. Now, I showed you in part two, Stephon Marbury, who lives in China. I basically gave you a small interview stating that he ain't never coming back to America. And why would he? The people treat him with respect and honor. Pay attention to these words. These words come in handy. They respect him and accept him for him. He goes over to China and wins some championships. You got black females that's in Germany who speak German. Her father is stationed in Germany, but she speaks, should learn how to speak German. Now we can put two and two together. She might have been complaining in the video, but we know SHU ladies who she might be dating. Okay? Then you got the black female who is in Russia. Why did she need to go to Russia? For all reasons why she went to Russia. But guess what? She learned how to speak Russian. Huh? Just like you got the black guy who went to China. He learned how to speak China. You got the black guys who moved to Japan, married a Japanese female, and clearly told you from the beginning, Japanese women love black people, especially black men. Brothers and sisters, understand this. We're thinning ourselves out. In the future, we gonna be mixed. Now the percentage right now is low. It's low. We know that. 1%, 2%. So it's low right now. But what's the percentage of us getting along? What's the percentage of black people, the man and woman, here in America getting along? That percentage is a lot higher. 45%. Is it accurate? No. Because we don't know everybody around the world. You're only going to know what you see around you. You're only going to know what's in your community. You only know what you see in some celebrities, how celebrities bounce from each other. Left and right. It's amazing, huh? But we as black people here in America, we got to wake up. Because we're losing this battle. It's nothing to be laughed about. And then the women, you got some strange behaviors going on. I read a little bit in part two. I'm going to read some more in part three. Yes, Shahrazad Ali, the black man's guide to understand the black woman. I'm going to tell you one thing. You better be meditating. Because a lot of black women believe they're supposed to dominate you. Where does a black baby learn this from? Huh? She learned this from her mother. She watched other women, how they treat their men. No matter if it's good or bad, sadly may case may be, but the baby watches that. and the baby will emulate it. It will emulate it. Don't get it twisted. We're gonna get in here deep. Let me give you a read a few. Chapter 1, her childhood. She learns to observe the other adults in the same way. She can detect when they are happy, at peace, or sadly, restrained, or mad. She also pays attention to how her mother treats her father. She learns glance, body languages, and moods. The spoken and unspoken message that her mother display. As the cup, she mimics and includes these practices. Right or wrong, as part of her survival skills from the very start. The very start, the young baby female, she's learning all these things. She overhears the conversation that her mother has with her friends or relatives pertaining to the father. If all the mother comments are supportive and positive, good, but since the habit of gaming on the black man is a 400-year-old tradition, here the inflection are for the most part negative. She listens and she records the first mental tapes translated into pictures and forms, and they cannot be erased. At least not for many years. What she overhears as a small child may be something like this. Pay attention. I don't care what your father said. I said I've got to cook and clean up this house before your father gets on, because I don't want to hear his mouth. Your father don't run this house. I do. He don't know what he's talking about. He don't know that I know. He don't know what he's doing. Sound familiar, huh? Let's get into that for a minute. Let's get into that. Disrespectful. And you don't even know that the women are disrespecting the man. How the women disrespects the men when they are not around. And who see this? The baby. And if they got a girl, she's watching it. Who sees this? The baby girl. She watches and listens how her mother disrespects the father. He don't know what he's talking about. He don't know that I know. He don't know what he's doing. Negative words this baby's picking up. So many of you black women do these things. You talk about the baby's father while you're not around. Oh, let's don't pretend like you don't do it. And then you only do that when you're around your friends or relatives. That complies the same thing. And you think this is the norm. But what you're doing is teaching your own child how to speak to their father, their brother, and how to speak to a man when he gets older in a negative tone. Because they're picturing these things. They're imagining these things. Let's move on. It's sad, ain't it? Okay, here we go. John makes me sick. Listen to the words. John makes me sick. I get tired of picking up behind him. If the father requests something she may hear the mother say, "Get it yourself." Or, "You don't tell me what to do. I do whatever I want to do." Sound familiar? In your house. Does it sound familiar in your home? Oh, do you do it? Every mother is guilty of using these or similar terminology about her husband when she is tired. She's exhausted or angry during the childhood's upbringing. The training messages from the mother, the teacher, is the black man don't know. 1, 2, certain references to the black man are made only behind his back. 3, a woman has the option to choose what she wants to obey. If I'm going to obey you, I don't know. I ain't got to if I don't want to. 4, a man is a bother. You a problem. You a problem. Huh? Just write notes. Remember, you gotta have your notes. Bear with me. I'm almost done. Almost. All right. Now, as I read that, right? What do you think the child is doing? You don't think that the child is understanding how you talking about their father? Huh? But let's get into a little bit more. Let's get into a little bit more. Here we go. After hearing vicious negative interference behind the father's back, then the girl child observes how the mother may front off when the father is present, pretending that she is obedient and everything is fine. Huh? The girl child, while too young to actually distinguish between truth and falsehood, watches how trusting and unaware the father is. Soon she concludes, pay attention now, concludes that the mother is right. He don't know, which must mean that he's dumb. And if he's dumb, he doesn't know what's going on behind his back. It makes the girl child, insecure. He's physically strong, but we live two lives, one in front of daddy and one behind his back. Since the mother is her mentor and they are alike, she agrees you can't trust him. Brothers and sisters, this go on in so many families. And if the man is not paying that no attention, he will not be able to see that. And even if he recognizes it, and he sees that the mother or the daughter is starting to play little games, well, we're talking about the mother right now, who's teaching her girl child, not knowing she's doing it. Not knowing, logically, you're teaching your daughter to not trust her father because he's not smart. He's dumb. You teach your children, and then as they get older, this cycle will begin to repeat itself. But let's go on. He is different from us, and the cycle starts. On the other hand, if there is no biological father or stepfather on the premises whom the girl child can relate to and observe daily, the scenario may go something like this, especially if the single mother is periodically changing men or dating around. Changing men or dating around because you want to do your thing and you want to do whatever you want. And don't know you bringing all this madness around your girl child. Let's continue. She may hear, I'm going to get the nigga tonight. One. Two. I keep calling him every night, but he ain't home. Three. Girl, don't believe nothing he says. He just lies all the time. Four. I can't believe nothing he says. Five. I'm going to make him spend money, some money on me. Six. I got to find me a man. Seven. I want to see what he can do. Eight. You can't let a man know all your business. The training message from the mother in this instance is, one, the black man is a liar. Don't believe in him. He'll disappoint you. Three, the black man will desert you. No security. Four, without holding information is a necessary practice when dealing with the black man. Five, and if you're going to deal with the black man, you have to have a plan. A plan. How many of you heard that? Girl, you know you gotta have a plan when you're dealing with a black man. I used to hear that. Aw, man, you stupid. I used to hear it. As many ways women do say things. And then when you get up and walk off and leave their ass, then they went, oh, forgive me, I didn't mean to do it. Nah. You meant everything what you was doing. Get the book, y'all. Self-explanatory. Let's get into some videos. The black man and the black woman, we at war. We at war with each other. We gotta come out. Especially in our inner communities. Our communities, you don't see the love camaraderie, the love connection, the affection, holding hands. You don't see that. And if you see it, it's from young couples. And it's rare. Very rare. It's like black people don't want to show emotions around each other. You can walk in some of these communities and you don't see it. You'll see young females with 5 or 6 kids by themselves. And in those 5 or 6 kids, 3 fathers, 4 fathers, making decisions to sleep with different men because you're trying to find a father figure and you don't know what a father figure is because you was trained by your own mama. She didn't know it. She didn't know she was down talking to you, disrespecting you. She thought it was the norm. They say 400 years. I believe longer than that. Because if you don't respect your father is your rock. Your father is the strength. And if you try to take away his mindset, his capabilities of thinking, you got women who believe that. That they trifling. You got women who literally, they in power, moving up to what I'm talking about, to a different thing. Women in power who likes to degrade men and try to make you feel stupid. Literally. They try to play you out of position. And if you don't make your stand, in sad case, you have to try to bite their fucking head off. Excuse my foul language. It's sad. But sometimes you got to do that to some of these women. It's in your own household. It's in your household. You see these things. That's why you as a father, if you're a father and you're around your child, you make sure that you are God. You make sure nothing get past you. I got four daughters. Now they got their own sneaky ways. Because they grown. But don't play that bull crap around me. I don't play that. And if I catch your sneaky ways, you gonna deal with it. So brothers and sisters, I'm gonna move on some clips. It's gonna be some clips that you might not like. But we got to find out why the black man and the black woman just don't get along. And I already showed you in the other clips, in the first the 1 and 2, how black men, they begin to shift themselves. They begin to shift with other cultures. Okay, they begin to shift and starting to make moves. So the black woman saying, and if you're gonna shift, I'ma shift. Now who's gonna love the black man and the black woman? If all these shifting is beginning to start to take place, other women from different cultures are starting to mess with black men. Other men and other cultures starting to mess with black women. So who's gonna mess with black men and black women? Who? And don't get it misconstrued. If you see another black man with a Spanish-speaking female or a female black woman speaking to a Spanish man, don't let that get you because he speaks Spanish. He's still black. She's still black. It's that their skin tone is mulatto, Creole, or lighter than yours. Because see, Spanish is not their culture. Puerto Rico is not their culture. That's a name that somebody had discovered that island. So-called. It was named after, probably a general, a captain, who discovered that island. Understand that. Where do Puerto Ricans come from? They're mixed culture, blending with black people, blending with the conquistadors, blending with the French, blending with the Spaniards. You blending with African slave females having babies. Huh? Don't let them fool you, brothers and sisters. But let me get in some new video. Get ready to be rocked.
A very, very requested, as YouTubers put it, requested question. The reason why I don't date black men. I decided I'll come out and tell you guys the real, true, honest to God reason. And what inspired me to make this video is because a couple of people, and by a couple I mean a couple hundred people, decided to comment on my videos, all the videos basically. There's always one person who's like, oh, you're a bed wedge, or you're a self-hating coon. You hate yourself and that's why you don't date black men. That's why you only date white men. I don't know why they got this impression, but I guess, you know, a lot of people just want their opinions to be heard and they just want to be understood or something. So I decided I'll come out here to explain the reason why I don't date black men to you guys. Before you pause this video and just scroll down and start making your derogatory comments and your misinformed comments, let me just say that information is untrue, it's false, it's incorrect, it is not true in any way at all that I don't date black men. It's fake news, okay? I think it's just ridiculous that people would assume that with no background whatsoever. They just look at me and they just make all these judgments that just make no sense. Like somebody said, I'm rich and stupid and conceited and stuck up. First of all, I'm not rich. A lot of you guys who were making these comments were from the U.S. You actually are from the U.S. You guys are Americans. I don't know if you're Zionists or one of those people who believe that Jah is going to come and take all his children back and only the black people will go to heaven and etc., etc., and black people are the only children of God. I think a lot of times Americans don't have the full picture of what it's like to be a black person in Italy. Yes, we do have a couple of us black Italo YouTubers out here, you know, trying to give you guys the information or just letting you guys know what it's like, but a lot of you just don't want to listen. I don't know why. We don't have a big community of black people like you guys do in America or in the UK or elsewhere. I know two black men, you guys. My brother and my brother's friend, who's not even in Italy anymore. I have no reason to hate myself. I am a beautiful black woman. It's not a narcissistic thing. It's not me trying to pump myself up or being all about self-love and all that. Yes, self-love is important, but it's a fact.
I'm gonna do you another video of another black woman expressing her opinion. That's all it is. They don't get all emotional. They're expressing their opinions, but don't let it escape from reality, because they're expressing these opinions and they also mean it to a degree, and some of them are living it. Let's get into it.
So I'm like noticing that there are so many black women who are like reading The Secret and going to pleasure parties, getting like concoctions and creating affirmations that are meant to attract a good black man to them. And honestly, I believe that that's a whole bunch of BS. Honestly, it's a whole bunch of BS. Because you're saying all this stuff. You're saying I am attracting a financially able black man. Or you're saying that I'm doing all these things. But what are you really committed to? Like, what are you really committed to? Like, you want a man who is focused on you, who is faithful, who loves you. But at the same time, you are not focused on yourself. You're talking to five different guys right now. You have one man that you're talking to, one man that you're effing, one man that you use to take you out to dinner, and one man who's like a phone buddy who you just speak to at all hours of the night just because you can't spend time by yourself. Or you want a man who provides for you, who plays his role as a man in your relationship, who loves you and who wants to provide for you. But you, when was the last time you studied the roles of womanhood? When was the last time you went in the kitchen and cooked up a meal? When was the last time you learned what it means to be submissive? When was the last time you learned what it means to communicate with a man? What kind of communication style a man has? What kind of communication style a woman has? What your man needs in terms of what his love language is? What men need? Like, men need respect. Like, when was the last time you understood that and learned that? Or you want someone who's authentic and you want someone who loves you to pieces and you want someone who is going to be that power couple where you just see love and power and all the success. But when was the last time you decided to be successful on your own? When was the last time you went out and tried to increase your power, try to increase your skills? When was the last time you loved the parts of you that you are expecting and demanding everybody else or a man to love? And then when you don't receive this man, you walk around saying black men ain't ish, black men ain't ish, when no, you're just committed to attracting black men that ain't ish because you're committed to a script. You're committed to living out a script that's gonna leave you lonely, independent, and just dealing with men who are living out that same script, who are in and out of your life. So really think about it. What are you committed to? All right.
Okay, brothers and sisters, gods and goddesses, kings and queens. Oh, that was some two good videos right there. See, reading from the book, Shahamza Ali, The Black Man's Guide to Understand the Black Woman. But here I gave you the video, similar explanations why these behaviors are taking place, because it's being trained. You see, we're gonna break this down. Now, I know some of you say, well, I already know all that. Some of you probably already know it. Some of you probably know, I didn't know this exists. I didn't know I was doing it. If you train your baby to hate her father because the father's not doing what you want, well, who chose them? Let me tell you something real quick. Women, you got the power. You got the power to tell a man yes or no. You got the power to tell a man, I want to be with you, or I'm not going to be with you. You got that power. So when you choose yourself an asshole, excuse my language, I'm looking for some action. I'm looking for a bad boy. I'm looking for somebody to entertain me. Oh, you're getting exactly what you're looking for. But you ain't looking for no man. You look for something to play with. You. Don't blame nobody but yourself. You heard the young lady stated. You got all these rules. You got 5, 6 different men around you for all these different little entertainments you want. Your insecurities is high up there. So you're trying to find a body for each one of these toys, if you will. But you cheat your child. Because the baby girl, as we read in the book, the girl child watches everything you do and listen to everything you do. And sooner or later, it will emulate that, what you do. And you be talking about, oh, my daughter's my best friend. Because now you got somebody, misery loves company. So you taught your daughter to be miserable. That's on the negative side. You could teach your daughter to be positive, and she would choose wisely. And if she gets herself to a man who's an asshole, she'll be able to get out of it. She'll be able to get out of that relationship, because the power between the mother and the father will unite inside her, and she'll be able to express herself and get out of that situation. Or she have to get it out herself because of your father or the mother wasn't there. So we got to be careful the things we do around our children when they're babies. The black man, the black woman, who should we be dating in the melanin race? Always getting deep. And why do we have a problem dating other melanin people? Is the language bothers you? But they're black. We'll be getting to all that. I'm SHU AMUN RA. Have a good one.